Hey everyone, Warwick's here. So we're back with Individual Project Month in November here. Last week we did Marwan Amon's Grim Grinning Ghost. Today we're going to look at his base gang cohort, Peter Barber, who did Enemy from the League of Legends show Arcane, which I was late to the party on initially and love. It's a great anime. You don't even have to know much about League of Legends to enjoy it. It's on Netflix. I strongly recommend go checking it out. 9 episodes. Around an hour long each, so a couple of days and you can have it all covered. Now, this is originally done by Imagine Dragons and JID, as Peter Barber notes here in the title of this. Now, Peter's been teasing this one for a while. I know that he did a lot of the work on this through supporters through his Patreon. He kind of fundraised the money through Patreon and some other methods, I'm sure, to be able to do this video, and I've been very excited to get it out. But I'm a little late to the party in terms of reacting to it quickly. I'm wanted to try and do it earlier, but some other stuff just kind of got in the way. So we're doing it now for release on, so I'm recording this on the 9th, so it'll release on the 13th, so just a few days from recording. So for those of you that are new to the channel, appreciate you very much for joining me on this. For those of you that are veterans of this channel, it's good to see you again. Welcome back. For those of you new, I'm not a professional musician. I'm just a guy who really loves music, enjoys. Started doing this back in June 2022, and these videos usually are very well received on my channel, so I just keep doing them because I still enjoy them. I enjoy the reactions that I get from people watching my reaction. Go from there. Now, I have not seen this video before, so this is going to be formatted as such. So I'm going to go through, I'm going to watch the whole thing. You're going to watch my unfiltered reaction. Now, if you've never seen this video yourself, you don't want this getting in the way of your experience, then I definitely recommend that you go to the description and click the original video link, because you're going to want to watch that. And then if you want to come back and watch my reaction to it, you can do that. After I get done watching the initial reaction, compose myself. Usually I have to compose myself when it comes to anything base gang member related. We'll dive back in and I'll be doing more of like an analysis and a breakdown of the stuff that I think is pretty cool. So that'll be like the second half of the video. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into Peter Barber's version of Enemy from League of Legends Arcane.
The sounds of the silence that allow for my mind to run around, with my ear up to the ground, I'm searching to behold the stories that I told, when my back is to the world that was smiling when I turned.
Tell me you're the greatest, but once you turn they hate us.
Oh, the misery, everybody wants to be my enemy.
Up on the wall as you're praying from a fall, and the laughter in the halls and the names that I've been called. I stack it in my mind and I'm waiting for the time when I show you what it's like to be worse than in a mic.
Tell you you're the greatest, but once you turn me
hate. Oh, the misery, everybody wants to be my enemy.
I'm hoping that somebody pray for me. I'm praying that somebody hope for me. I'm scared where nobody supposed to be, but proposed being a wreck of emotions, ready to go whenever. Just let me know the road is long, so put the pedal into the flow. The enemy will share my energy unavailable. I'ma tell them all the way, go there when I fly. I'ma drive to the top, I'm out of shape, thinking of the box. I'm an astronaut, I blasted off the planet, brought to cause catastrophe, and it matters more, cause I had not had a thought about wreaking havoc on an opposition. Kinda shocking, they want us at a cool position. I'm automatic quarterback, I ain't talking second, pack it, back it up. I don't panic, better, better, put it better, so don't matter, cause we ain't just
everybody wants to be my enemy.
Barber sympathy. Everybody wants to be my enemy.
Interesting. Let me mute this real quick because I know it's going to play ads. Okay. Wow, that was nowhere close to what I was expecting. And I don't mean that in a bad way. He took a pop rock song and turned it into like a heavy dubstep synth remix. And it worked. He also got the that was really cool for how just different it was. Like, this was I can't even describe it. Like, it kind of just melted my brain. Staring at this palm tree across the street trying to find words. Very, very, very different. Took aspects of it and like added a lot of different genres to it. Because like, you know, you hear Imagine Dragons, like you think, to be fair, they have a very specific style of music, which is rarely deviated from, and it's been a highly successful formula for them for over a decade now. And he just took that and basically just shredded it all to pieces and was like, nah, we're gonna do this in a very different way. Very cool, Peter. Kudos, sir. Really enjoyed that. Very, very creative. Ton of stuff going on visually there too that is really cool. A lot of really nice little Easter eggs. If you are a fan of the show or you're a big fan of League of Legends, I saw a few Easter eggs in there that were really cool. Let's see what he says here at the top. Without a shed of a doubt, this is my crowning achievement as an artist. Endless incomparable thank yous to all who supported me through the process. We donated towards the $15,000 required to make this music video, along with the behind-the-scenes mini documentary. I simply could not accomplish this without you. If you want to see more music videos like this, consider joining Patreon or donating to the music video fund directly. All right, so let's take a look. We're going to read over some of the comments, and then we're going to go give the props to the behind-the-scenes folks. Mortius, one of my favorite people to watch. Watched it for the premiere. It was just as good as the literal 20 times I listened to the early access. So proud. And if you're reading this, make sure you like the video and leave your own comment. Get the masterpiece out there for everyone to see. Yeah, I'm definitely going to be commenting on this after this video. Marwan, arrangement to audio to video. He loves it. RTS bass giving us some low notes. Peter replies. Sneaky B1 in chest. We'll have to see. But yeah, lots of B1s going on throughout here, which B1 D2 chest, B1 chest is the opening note, which are things that we don't really hear from Peter all that often. At least in my experience with him. See Casper, this is incredible. Casper, of course, who put me in one of his videos as well for a moment of silence. Yeah, very, very, yeah. This deserves everything that it's getting. Let's see. Audio is arranged, recorded, mixed, and mastered by Peter. Beverly Boy Productions did the production support. Felice Riley was your producer-director. Brian Scheimer, director of photography. He moved down so you could see it. Jonathan Charles is the gaffer, Kelly Sterling the makeup artist, Tom McCoy did the BTS video, and David Odius the editor. Shoutouts to all you guys for collaborating with Peter on this. You guys get applause as well. This might be the best arrangement that I've heard from Peter, and I know he did Yellow Flicker Beat, I know he did Bones, but I think this is by far the best, and it really shows off his skill. So, fantastic stuff. All right. So for those of you just for the reaction, that's the end of the video for you. Thank you for joining me. For those of you who want to nerd out, let's get into it. So before we get into the breakdown, a couple things that I want to make note of. I heard his opera technique. I heard, of course, his B1 and chest, as we got right here. We see his absolute love and adoration for electronic dubstep music. And we get a little bit of a sign of his range on this. And so he kind of shows off like everything that he could do from a music standpoint. So let's keep that in mind as we're going forward here. All right, so before we get into the first chorus here, I kind of want to show, at least for me, what I thought was a really cool indication at the very beginning of what this video is going to look like. And it involves his silhouettes right here. So if you've not watched Arcane League of Legends, I'm not going to spoil anything from here. But one of the characters, one of the main characters who's known as, has two different names in the series, has a real problem with... trying to decide the best way to describe Jinx. She has a problem kind of having a broad scope of things, and because of that she goes into like these manic, panic, potentially drug induced. I don't know too much of the lore of League of Legends. I don't play a lot of the stuff, but just from the show, like, she goes through a really tough time, and as a result of that, she has very, like, manic breakdowns that result in a lot of, like, all-over movement, 80, you know, like, bouncing off the wall type stuff, and it's kind of shown a little bit here at the beginning with the change in all the silhouettes. And his movements with the jerky head. Yeah, and the lookout for yourself is also kind of like a theme of the early part of the show, where the two main characters kind of learn that style of lesson through some very important events, without spoilers.
Sounds of the silence that allow for my mind to run around, with my ear up to the ground. I'm searching to behold the stories that I told, with my back is to the world that was smiling when I turned.
Yeah, and then that section there, of course, the little shout-out tattoo, or I think V has one of those in the show. Again, no spoilers, but for the most part, what I like about that beginning from a musical perspective is the fact that you have distinct left and right ears, if you listen on good headphones, that really creates this surround sounds type effect that also allows it for both voices to be really distinct, and they both work in harmony, but also almost sound like they shouldn't. Like, so there's like this idea that it shouldn't sound good, but it does somehow. At least that's the feeling I got out of it. And that's what I really enjoyed about this section. And he does it a couple more times throughout the piece, as we'll point out as we go through it. But right off the start, like, again, he kind of sets this tone for what this is going to kind of be like. And so right there, he kind of maintains that with that kind of left-right ear, like, instead of being like this in terms of the harmony, it sounds like it's like this, where one's just off enough, but it still works. And then, of course, on the low end, he throws in his opera training, so which adds a level of character without it becoming, you know, whereas, like, he kind of makes just a little shift to keep your ears interested. You know, he likes to talk a lot about contrast, doing a lot of that here. I like talking about keeping your ears interested. And by that, it means like tuning out. There's a reason why, like, you know, lo-fi and deep meditation and sleep music works. It's because it's repetitive and it's meant to just drown out and kind of infect your mind and drown out everything else. Whereas for something like this, you want to entertain. You want people to enjoy it and feel the groove and be part of it. And so in those style of songs, trance is kind of the same way, where, you know, things tend to run along just this one plane as you're going across, because it's kind of meant to let you get lost into that one sound and you really just kind of absorb it. Here, because he's wanting to entertain you and keep you engaged and keep you attracted to what he's doing, you know, it's vital that you have these little shifts going on throughout that make you go, huh? Like, you know, almost like the squirrel type thing. And so he does a good job of that. And, you know, most good artists do. It's very simple, but I think a lot of people get caught and stuck in their melodies. And so they like to ride them for as long as possible because they love them. Where here they don't, you know, a lot of good artists will recognize, like, when is it a good point to change up? Whether it's, you know, it's kind of music composition 101. And he does a good job with that, both, you know, from a music standpoint, it's just those big heavy hits with the snares in between. But vocally, he's able to add that, those little sways that keep you interested. Also, Peter, I think I got shirts to wash. Can I use your abs, sir? I think I got a shirt over there somewhere. Brother in Fitness, not me. Obviously, I'm a little overweight, but I know you enjoy yourself a workout or two. It shows, sir. Thank you. Okay, so right here, we're still keeping kind of that operatic lower end going on in the background with the main chorus, whereas he's also singing kind of a more traditional method that you would think with this song. And again, there's enough of a conflict there. Like, this song feels like it has, like it just doesn't know what it wants to settle on, but it's being done in a way that is very effective. And in a way that doesn't sound off-putting. Like, I've been guilty definitely of saying, like, oh, this isn't my favorite thing from XYZ artist. I've done it with the bass gang that he's a part of. And then, like, I find myself keep coming back to the song, like, Bones. I think in my video for that, I even said, like, oh, this isn't my favorite thing from the bass gang. But then I've gone back and just listened to everything that they put out, and I find myself just grooving and jamming along. You know, I know this is going to probably put some people off on the first time they listen to it, but I think the more you listen to it, the more you're going to be able to just sit there and appreciate everything that's going on. And again, this is a song much like the main characters of Arcane that, you know, they really struggle with kind of understanding where they fit in the world, where they, you know, what they want to do. They want to make an impact, but at the same time, they want to stay safe. And like, this song is like, just through the vocal quality, where you have this opera, this traditional singing, this low bass, this dubstep backstep, like it engages all those feelings in me, at least for me, where, you know, you're getting this sense of like, so many things are going on. What do I do? What do I settle on? And he's accomplishing that, in my opinion. Plus with the visuals, this like very jerky movements, these kind of weird, like here you got like magnifying glasses, these shadow silhouettes. It just all amplifies into like, almost like a level of anxiety that he's trying to like instill in you during this video. You know, because of course the idea of the song is that like people will be very kind, sweet, gentle to you and to your face. And then once, you know, I think one of the main lines that people take away is, tell me you're the greatest. But once they turn, they hate us. Or once you turn, they hate us. So it's like people are always like kind to you, but then behind your back, they're like, screw that person. You know, very much that what we call rat behavior, at least in my neck of the woods, where people, or the weasel behavior, or that mirror behavior, where you, like, there's all sorts of names that people call it depending on where you're from. That's kind of this theme of this song, and kind of a little bit of the theme of the show, if you watch the show. And so he's kind of fitting that in visually as well. Really nice. So right there, let's see, 108, 107. So what was that? RTS, bring us back. Thank you. Thank you, computer. Catch up. 107, D1 and D2 chest. Okay. That's what a lot of these are going to be. And now we're back to the beginning original line, except this time the high note is a little bit higher, but his low is exactly where it was in the beginning. So again, giving you something familiar, but also giving you something new. Really nice contrast there.
After when the holes and the names that I've been called, I stack it in my mind, and I'm waiting for the time when I show you what it's like to be worse fit in a mic.
And our opera again. Okay, that section's creepy. I personally find the idea of when you open your mouth, like you just see right through, like there's no, like I, that idea of like creepy shadows almost is like one of my favorite concepts, and that is like done very, very well there. I don't know if that was intended, but like, ooh, nah, get me out of there. Getting into that high note, I'm not going to even attempt it, but just like the original does, which I really like. Ooh, my enemy. 145-ish. Thank you. 144 again. B1, D2s. B-flat 1. I didn't catch that, but I'm not good at identifying notes. So I like that he also puts some ode to the original with that one set of high notes there. You know, some ode to the original, because this is like taking this song and reimagining it in a completely new way, which, you know, reimagining from a song called Imagine Dragons, teehee. But I like that he's still putting these odes to the original other than just, you know, the lyrics. But like, even like musically, he's adding in these little like nods towards the original song, which is a very good song. One of my favorites from them. The style of symbology going on here, very reminiscent of the show.
Okay, I'm hoping that somebody pray for me. I'm praying that somebody hope for me. I'm staying where nobody supposed to be, but posted, being a wreck of emotions. Ready to go whenever, just let me know. The road is long, so put the pedal into the flow. The enemy of my dream, energy unavailable. I'm a thought I'm lost, way go there. When I'm blind, I'm a drive to the top. I'm another shape, thinking of the box. I'm an astronaut, I'm blasted off the planet. Rock to cause catastrophe, and it matters more. Cause I had not had a thought about wreaking havoc on an opposition. Kinda shocking, they want us in a cool position. I'm automatic, quarterback, I ain't talking second. Pack it, back it up, I don't panic. Better, put it better, so don't matter. Cause we ain't
control. Everybody wants to be my.
My favorite section of the song right there. Yeah, I watched it completely through again and just enjoyed it. So a few things about that, obviously, very much a different style. So we've gotten this heavy dubstep, a little bit of the rock opera. Now we're just getting this straight up rap in terms of the approach to the lyrics. Obviously not music style, but the things that I find really, really interesting about this is that he did this in his notes. Like, he maintained it. Like, with rapping, you know, one of the things that you hear a lot about it is that it can sometimes sound like just really fast talking. You know, there are some artists that, some rappers that can do it very well in terms of doing it in voice, but there are a lot of rappers that it just sounds like they're talking really fast. And here he maintained these levels of these notes throughout the entire thing. And I can't imagine how difficult it was for him to do that. So that, to me, more shout outs, Peter. I love this section. It's my favorite one of the entire piece because I both appreciate the fact that it's a very different change, something that, as far as I've dug into the catalog of both you and the Bass Gang, you guys haven't done before. So very cool. Shows off, again, a different aspect of your skill. But at the same time, also goes through and has this level of musicality to it that is... for me, as someone that understands basic musicality, it has like this level of difficulty that I imagine, as someone that's not a great singer, that probably was really hard to record, and I wonder how many takes it took him to get that right. Some really high notes in the background there. that except probably one or two octaves higher. Right there. So again, at the end there, another kind of tribute to the original song, where they have that in there, and of course even the deep my enemy, very similar to what different singing style, but I think roughly the same notes as what Jeff did in the voice play cover. So if you know those notes, that's probably what these notes were, but again, RTS bass will label it out for us here. So let's go check. Let's see, we're looking at the end around 247, some more D1, D2s. So, yeah, so D1, D2s again, just really, really good stuff, showing off a wide, wide range here. I think this is fantastic work, and he, you know, you can tell he's proud of it from his description and stuff like that. I love the costumes here, so again, I don't know if Kelly did also some of the costume work, or if this is just stuff Peter has laying around in his closet, from multiple gigs that he's done, or different video styles that he's done with like the Bass Gang or some other groups. But like, costuming in this is really cool. Lots of really nice little nods to Arcane the show, nice little nods to the Imagine Dragons original song, and then done in a way that is completely reimagined and almost gives new life to the song in a way. So absolute fantastic work, Peter. Thank you so much for sharing it, creating it, working on it, and allowing, you know, someone like me to enjoy it in this space. And I hope that you, my viewers, do as well. So I'm going to go ahead and wrap this up here, guys. Thank you so much. Go watch the original. Go sub to Peter. He absolutely deserves it. 61,000. Let's get this man to 70,000 as soon as possible. Let's get him. Hell, let's get him his YouTube plaque with 100,000. Let's get him there. Sub to his channel. Support him on Patreon if you can. I'm sure you get a lot of great stuff there. Right now, unfortunately, I cannot support on Patreon, but once some things change, hopefully for me in the near future, we'll be supporting those folks. So until the next video, I hope you all staying safe. I hope you're enjoying yourself. You're having fun. You're listening to great music, and I will see you all in the next video.